Hey, this is John, and I'm going to start off with a very, very big and bold statement. If you haven't yet achieved some of your life's biggest goals and dreams, I want you to know it's not your fault, and I'll show you why today and in the next few mini video training sessions I'm going to send you over the next several days. I'd like to start off with a short story that changed my life and pretty much guaranteed my financial and life success. And it happened about 35 years ago. And when you follow what I'm about to share with you today and in the next few videos, it can guarantee your success when you listen, learn, and apply it. Now, some of you may know that my father was a cab driver, my mom worked at a local department store as a seamstress, and I was on the path when I was a kid to being in jail or the morgue. However, when I was 19 years old, I met this gentleman who really was willing to take me under his wing and teach me how to set and achieve goals. And up until that time, I used to look at the TV show Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, and I used to dream about, you know, living in a nice home and having nice cars and traveling to great places. And what I can share with you is those dreams ended up becoming a reality for me. And the question is, what changed within me so that my life could change? And there's two things I'd like to share with you. Number one is I learned a process that most people have never learned. And the first part of what I learned was obviously something you already know. It's the importance of setting very, very specific goals, which is what everybody knows to do. But what I also learned that most people don't ever learn is how the different parts of my brain were responsible for helping me achieve my goals or sabotage my goals and my plans. And when I learned to activate and use both parts of my brain in the right way, my results started to skyrocket. I've written 3 books, 2 New York Times best-selling ones, been in 8 movies, I've traveled the world, I've lived a pretty nice lifestyle, I get to donate my time and money to the charities that I love, and so does my family. And the reason I'm sharing this with you is because when most people set goals, they don't recognize or they haven't been taught that setting goals uses your conscious imagination and deductive reasoning factor in your brain, 2 of your higher faculties of mind. And an image that I want you to take a look at is this image with the flea and an elephant. And imagine having the flea try to tell the elephant where to go. Well, you already know the answer. The elephant's going to do what it wants to do. And the reason I'm using this visual for you is because your conscious mind is responsible to choose what you want to achieve, but it's your unconscious mind that's the elephant that will go wherever it's been conditioned to go to. And so what I would like you to do is understand that not only do you need to learn how to set goals, and hopefully you started thinking about how to set goals, all right, with the Exceptional Life Blueprint that I sent you in the last few days or so. And if you haven't, then I want you to take a look at this. But what I want to do today is I want to focus on getting you to dream again. And I want you to focus on what you really want to achieve, not what you think you can achieve or what you have achieved. And what I can share with you is when I was 19 years old and my mentor said to me, "What do you want to trade your life for?" I wrote down, you know, I want to trade my life for paying my rent, for being able to pay the lease on my car, to be able to have enough money to, you know, go out to restaurants and the bars. And he said to me, "Why are you setting your goals so low?" And the truth was because I didn't have the self-confidence or the certainty that I could set bigger goals. And what he shared with me was this. He said, "Take your imagination and write down all the goals for what it is that you want to achieve in health, wealth, relationships, career, business, finances, fun, experiences. As much as you can dream and imagine," he says, "use that part of your brain, like the flea, the small part of your brain, like the flea, to choose what you want to achieve." He said, then You take that information and you use your other part of your brain to be able to help you achieve those goals. Now, let me explain something to you about the neuroscience of goal achievement. When you set a goal for something that you don't yet know how to achieve, and you see that goal in front of you, usually it'll cause some excitement in you and dopamine will be released in the brain. That's the feel-good drug. But as soon as that happens, another part of the brain takes over that comes up with all of the excuses and stories and reasons why you can't achieve that goal. It's the error detection mechanism in the brain, which is the default mechanism in the brain that kicks in. And what happens is most people don't understand that this is just how the process works, but they can override that process and really start to work towards their goals and dreams. The other thing that happens when you set a goal that you really want to achieve and you see it in your mind's eye, you're activating the occipital lobe part of your brain and you're activating other little mechanisms in the brain that causes motivation to be really, really high. Now, the key is to keep that motivation high versus allowing the other parts of your brain to trip you up and cause you to have procrastination or excuses or tell yourself stories as to why you can't achieve it. Let me give you a couple things just to think about. When John F. Kennedy wanted to send a rocket ship and a human to the moon, they didn't know how to achieve it yet. When Bill Gates wanted a computer in every home, that was a vision and a dream. When Steve Jobs said, I'm going to put 1,000 songs, in your pocket, initially, when they had the vision or the goal or dream, they didn't know how to achieve it. And in many cases, the technology didn't even exist. And here's something I learned. How to achieve a goal will always come after you set the goal. And so one of the things I would really like you to do is to start dreaming again like you did when you were younger and you didn't have a lot of fears. And if you've already downloaded the Exceptional Life Blueprint, you'll see on page number 14, okay, there's a document that you could fill out for your goals for 2016. And what I'd like you to do is get clear first, okay, on what do you want to achieve in your health. So your spiritual health, mental health, emotional health, physical health. What financial wealth do you want to see in 2016? Your net worth and your income. What specifically would you like your relationships to look like and feel like? If you have a business or you want to start a business, what is the goal for your business? What about charitable contributions of time or money? What about fun and experiences and having some amazing, fun experiences in your life? Contribution to your neighborhood, to people in your community center, to people around the world. What books do you want to read? What courses do you want to take? What I'd like you to do is I want you to dare to dream again, and I'll show you how to achieve your goals, okay? Don't worry about how yet. Get clear on what. And I'm going to show you over the next 2 or 3 videos how to get the goals that you have put on paper, okay, or on your computer, and I'm gonna get those goals into the other part of your brain. And what we're gonna focus on is the critical things that you need to do to keep your motivation high so that you don't just set goals and stop them, which is what most people do within 7 days. I want you to be motivated to achieve your goals and use your brain and your emotions and your physical body to move you in that direction every single day. And I'll show you how to not sabotage your success while you stay motivated to achieve your goals, regardless of what has happened in the past. Because a lot of times when I talk to people about setting goals and achieving goals, they feel like they're not smart enough or they're doing the wrong things. They don't know whether they can really achieve those goals. And so what I can share with you is I've helped hundreds of thousands of people set and achieve goals, and I'm gonna help you as well. What I'd like you to do is commit, okay, to going through the process, all right, and getting clear first is the first process that you wanna get to. And so download the document if you haven't already. It's free. And then Pay attention to the next few videos, all right? And get clear on your goals. I'll show you some amazing stuff in the next few videos that'll help go from goal setting to goal achieving. So for now, what I'd love you to do is, just so we can have some dialogue here, is share one of your top goals with me for the next 6 to 12 months. And after you do that, just click the share button and help me spread the love and help me spread the training around, all right? So let's get that done. Put one goal down, hit the share button, and get clear on your goals in the next, let's say, 12 hours.